fourth quarter. Last 2 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
Gotta get a bucket. Who do they go to? Joel Embiid, the process. Is he gonna come out on top or not? Let's see.
Hey, what's going on, everybody? For First We Feast, I'm Sean Evans, and you're watching Hot Ones. It's the show with hot questions and even hotter wings. And today I'm joined by Sixers big man, Joel Embiid. He's an NBA All-Star, a fan favorite in Philadelphia, and you can catch him on the cover of NBA Live 19 dropping this fall. But enough chit-chat. How does he handle some of the hottest chicken wings on planet Earth? We'll find out today, JoJo. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
And then I know that you used to go to Jefferson's when you were at the University of Kansas and you'd get the double-dipped turbo wings. So I take it you're pretty good with spicy food?
Yeah, I'm used to, you know, being from Africa. There's a lot of spice out there and that's how we eat. So pretty used to, so I'm excited. So far, nothing.
So far, chill.
Nope.
So lately you've been in the headlines for crashing these playground basketball games and then savagely dunking on civilians. I'm curious, how does this all come together? Do you set these things up or do you just see people hooping in the playground and decide to crash the game?
A lot of times I'm kind of tempted because as I'm leaving the tennis court when I'm done, some guys will come and, you know, talk trash, talk about, oh, I can dunk on you, I can cross you up, or I can score on you. And usually a lot of people like to disrespect NBA players, and I don't like that. So, you know, at times when I feel like it, I feel like I should teach them a lesson. And that's why I stop by and I do my thing and then I leave.
Do you have a favorite play? I'd like to call out one of mine. It's when you bounce the ball off that guy's face and then windmill dunked on him.
That has to be the favorite one. That one was pretty good. I just did it on the fly, and the whole time it was kind of going too hard. I was there for like 5 minutes, and he was like really going at me. He was scoring the ball, and then I was like, you don't want to get me started. And then that's when I bounced off his head and windmill on him. I mean, what can you do after that? You can't really do anything. And then there was a lot of people watching too. So like, he enjoyed it at the end. You know, everybody shook hands and I shook everybody's hands and I left. Still nothing.
Child's play.
Well.
So as we've talked about, you've really thrown yourself into Philly life, hitting these playground courts and jogging on the street Rocky style.
Yo, trust the process! I love you!
Do you remember the first time you met Allen Iverson? Did he give you any advice?
I do. That was at the time when I was going through my injuries and I wasn't able to play. And he was always telling me, you're going to be the one. And then nowadays when he sees me, he's so proud and he always talks about, yeah, that's what I told everybody. I told you, I knew you were going to be that guy.
What do you remember about that night that Meek Mill rang the 76ers Liberty Bell after he was released from prison?
It was an emotional night. You know, him coming out of jail and us being in an important playoff game to close it out at home. Thought it was a great setup. We enjoyed having him and celebrating him getting out of jail, and I had a lot of fun.
Have you picked up any Philly slang? People really talk differently over there, it seems.
What's the most common that I always hear? Young boy, something like that. They don't say boy, they say, look at that young boy. At times, I think I catch myself like using it because I've been there for so long. Perfectly fine.
So you're on the cover of NBA Live, which also features cameos from complex anchors. And in last year's game, your player rating was an 88. What do you expect it to be this year?
Well, if I'm on the carbon, I mean, you gotta believe that I'm gonna be at least a 95.
A 95.
Yes. That and if I'm not, I'm gonna work for it and get to 95.
Your teammate TJ McConnell said that you talked the most crap ever and that he'll never play video games with you again. What do you remember about the afternoon where he almost threw a controller out of your apartment building window?
I'm actually really good at everything I do, especially video games related. And I was beating the shit out of him. He was about to cry, and I was enjoying it because that's what I like doing. I like kicking people's ass and literally being like in their faces, letting them know that they suck, they are trash, and that I'm better than them. Even on the court, he just gets mad about anything. I'm like, dude, just calm down. And that day, it wasn't a good day for him, but it was really bad. I can understand his frustration because I'm that good.
Do you ever put on the headset and play randos on the internet?
Yeah, I've done it a few times.
Do they know it's you?
I think I've been in one situation where someone actually recognized me because of the way I talk, but it's like usually it's better when they don't recognize me because I can talk the most shit and I can say whatever I want and he's not going to be like...
Clip it out and put this. It on TMZ.
Yeah, I was saying all this and that, so it's better that way. Son of zombie.
Good?
Yep.
So since moving to the U.S. when you were 16, you've been totally immersed in American pop culture. And in fact, one of your high school teammates, D'Angelo Russell, said that when you were still developing your English, you used to just use Rick Ross quotes to respond to people. Do you remember any of the lines that you would use?
Those used to be my songs. Listening to a song and then going and like looking at the lyrics and trying to memorize. And then that's how like a lot of words just kind of stuck in my mind.
This summer has been one of the more memorable ones in recent history for hip hop. You have everyone from Kanye to Nas to Jay-Z and Beyonce dropping an album. And of course, as this episode drops, it's the week of Drake's release. Right. Who do you think is going to have the hottest record this summer?
Well, Drake is really good at what he does. Obviously, every time he comes out with a song, he's always a hit. So my guess would be Drake.
Mm-mm. Still no problem.
No problem.
Do you still feel confident that you'll get through this, no water, no milk?
There's only five more, so it's great.
All right, Joel, well, we have a recurring segment on our show called Explain That Gram, where we do a deep dive on our guest's Instagram, pull interesting pictures that need more context. So I'll show you the picture, and then you just tell me the bigger story. Does that sound good?
Yep.
All right, laptop, please. Thank you, Bill.
You're welcome.
2 Chainz has this reputation for being the best basketball player in hip-hop. Does he live up to that reputation?
That day, he was a little rusty. He said that was like his first game back since he was injured. I give him the benefit of the doubt, but he was slow. You know, he couldn't really move, get by nobody. But he has a nice stroke.
He can shoot.
Yeah, he can shoot the ball.
You and MJ.
That was in New Orleans, my first All-Star. So, and then just happened to be at a party, and I met the who they consider the GOAT, and he has a pretty good resume to be the GOAT. So I felt like it was a great idea to, take a picture with him.
How'd he take that? Sometimes people have MJ stories where he's a little bit rough about the picture.
No, he was great. He was amazing. It was no problem. It was cool. And I think he wanted it too. Easy.
No problem. Poker face. Careful around your eyes, you know?
Easy.
So in 2012, you tweeted, ate 10 cheeseburgers, had fun, ate Cameroonian food. Is that just the average cheat meal for you?
Back home, I used to eat a lot, but I could never put on some weight. And then as soon as I got to the state,
I was still eating a lot, so 10 cheeseburgers. Back in the day, it was definitely a regular night for me.
Do you remember the first time you tried Nutella? That always seems like it's a big moment for a lot of people.
Nutella? Well, I'm still in love with Nutella. I don't eat it as much as I used to, but I used to literally eat out of the jar, use my finger and just freaking eat one jar every day. Now I'm like, gotta take care of myself, and now I'm responsible. So I have a lot of responsibilities, so I gotta do a better job. But back in the day, I used to be savage.
Yeah, you cut a croissant in half, right?
And make a Nutella sandwich.
Eat with my fingers. What do you think is your record for the most Nutella sandwiches you've ever eaten in one sitting?
I don't know. A lot. Because I've got to be responsible.
Listen, I know. You've turned the page and now you're eating right and hitting. I know. But in your day, you could put away more than five Nutella sandwiches?
Yes.
More than 10 Nutella sandwiches?
I can't stay and do it.
More than 15 Nutella sandwiches?
I mean, if there was money on the line, I could definitely eat more than 15. Which one is this?
Bunsters. It's from Australia.
Wait, is that the one Ben was having? One of my teammates, Ben, was having...
Ben Simmons.
Yeah, he was having people try some type of hot sauce, and it was really, really bad. He said he was from Australia, and everybody was like, don't do it. I hope it's not that. Easy.
So outside of basketball, I know that your other great love is soccer. I've heard you say that if hoops hadn't swept you up, that maybe you'd play for the Cameroon national team. Would you say that you're the best soccer player in the NBA?
Right now, yes. Right now, yes. Steve Nash, when he was in the NBA,
great.
Yes, that was there. And he's really good. But I would say right now, I used to be so skilled. I was the best in my neighborhood. And then it was good. Yeah, I love soccer. That's what we call it, football. That's the real football. So that was my first love.
And then I've seen you cheering for Arsenal, wearing a custom jersey from Chelsea, and then shouting out Tottenham for supporting the process. What's the Premier League team that you root for?
Arsenal. I'm a Gunner. My favorite team overall is Real Madrid. But in every league, I have a favorite team, and in England, is Premier League is Arsenal.
All right, Joel, you ready to move on?
Not yet. Great.
So I'm not sure if you remember, but back in 2014, I had the pleasure of interviewing you at the beginning of your online courtship with Rihanna, which has only gained momentum in the time since. And listen, your personal life is your personal life, Joel. I'm not trying to pry, but I am curious in the tactics. Why'd you think it was important to express your affection publicly rather than just slide in the DMs, which most people would do?
I don't slide in DMs. Something that I've always been scared of. You know, I'm a jokester. The whole thing with Rihanna is all fun. Yeah, it's all fun.
What's the best Riri song to make sweet love to, in your opinion?
Rude Boy. Because I'm a rude boy. I'm not ready yet.
We'll chill. Still no water, no milk. It's right there.
I'm a warrior.
Here we go, my man. find it.
Oh, God. Fourth quarter. Last 2 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
Gotta get a bucket. Who do they go to? Joel Embiid, the process. Is he gonna come out on top or not? Let's see. Easy.
So Philly has this reputation for having the most brutal, savage fans in pro sports, but it seems like your experience was the exact opposite. I've heard you talk about, especially early on when you were dealing with injuries in your career, how they were supportive and caring. What does the media get wrong about Philly fans? Is there a softer side?
Yeah, you just gotta know. Oh, you needed some milk?
Joel, I'm not out here trying to prove anything, you know?
Okay. Philly fans, you got to understand that they've always treated me well. They've always supported me, even after missing 2 years, which I really appreciate it. They will fight for you. Some guys get it, some guys don't. So process is everything. Process is life.
Process is life, Joel Embiid.
Last one.
And sauce is life. This is the last dab, Redux. We call it the last dab because it's tradition around here to put a little extra.
No.
On the last wing.
Wow.
You don't have to if you don't want to, Joel.
So I gotta do it?
You don't have to if you don't want to.
Gotta trust the process. Let's do it.
Oh my God.
Oh, it's too much.
Well, you know what? You've said so far, every wing, it's light work. It's chill. It's no problem. So you should have no problem with that. But if you want to switch, we can switch.
Nice, cool.
Respect.
Nice.
Joel Embiid, cleaning wings on hot ones, taking it out, running the gauntlet.
Great.
All right, Joel Embiid, here we are at the end of the line. Riding a chicken wing wave and the clock is ticking down. I have two more questions for you and a challenge. If you were going to talk trash to one of these sauces, which one would you choose and what would you say?
Which was the hottest one? I think this one was the hottest one. I mean, first of all, that's a dumbass name. You're a fool. I can't really think straight right now.
We're sending you home with a bottle of the last dab. If you were to prank any NBA player by spiking their meal, which NBA player would you prank?
Who doesn't like spikes on the team? Probably like JJ.
JJ Redick. And then finally, a challenge for you. You know, you've impressed and wowed the internet time and time again with the sheer size of your hand. So I'm curious, how many of these bottles do you think you could palm at one time?
See, I'll go with the big guns. Hold on.
Fascinating stuff. He's got four. Five. Can he do one more? Six. Seven. No way. Eight.
I think that's it.
Hold it up. He's got eight bottles. That's eight bottles, nearly the table. I don't know if it's a record, but it might be.
It might
and now
be.
There's nothing left to do, Joel Embiid, but roll out the red carpet for you, my friend. This camera. Let the people know what you have going on in your life.
Oh, what I have going on in my life? Well, on September 7th, I'm gonna be on the cover of NBA Live 19. Pre-order now, so I'm excited about this. I've been dreaming about this, since I started playing basketball, and it's gonna be fun.
Good job, my man, good job.
Thank you. Did all the guys, did they drink a lot of water?
So you know what's funny is the athletes get competitive. So they're kind of like you, like Sam McKevy's like, I think I can go. You know, like, so even the way that you were like, three more. You know, like that, like they would do that same thing, you know? This is funny.
But did they drink though?
You're the only NBA player who did not drink water or milk. Yeah, you got
through. I'm used to, Africans, we're used to a lot of like spices and stuff, so like.
So listen, yeah. No, so you'll forever have that one, Joel. They can't take that away from you.
Can't take that from me.
So what they'll do here is this slow zoom in on us for the opening sequence, so we could just be like. Aloha, Spice Lords. If you're wondering why I'm sitting on this beautiful beach, it's because I'm celebrating Los Calientes, the sauce of summer and the newest addition to the Hot Ones hot sauce family. This is Beach Vibes in a Bottle. Sweet, smoky, spicy. And I might be biased, but I think it's the best hot sauce we've ever made. And here's the exciting news. If you want to pick up a bottle, it's available now. You know the drill. Heatness.com for your bottle of Los Calientes. Los Calientes. Muy delicioso.